Hey there, solar folk. I am the Solar Boy, and it has been like 3 weeks since RE Plus, and I went, and it was great. And if you saw me there, it was great to see you. And if I didn't see you there, sorry I missed you. If you're not familiar with RE Plus, it is the biggest solar conference, at least in the US. So if there's somebody you want to talk to, they're probably at the conference, and it's a good place to do networking, follow up with manufacturers you work with, all that jazz. I personally had a great time, aside from my personal jobby job duties, like doing the sad, unfortunate talks with manufacturers about why isn't your crap working. An absurd number of people recognized me this year, and I got to do cool things like partner with Suncast that runs the media booth at RE+. I did some segments for them, those are on the YouTube, and I also got to do a video podcast panel of like wrapping up our thoughts about RE+ with Nico Johnson, Joe Ordia, and Martina Kowalczyk. It's Polish, so I'm definitely not pronouncing that right. And it's so fun. I got to meet a lot of people I wanted to meet this year. I got to connect with a lot of people that I've already met from last year. I got to bring my wife along to help me shoot videos. There's a lot of videos I still need to edit and upload to the channel for you guys. It was a good week. It was a good week for the Solar Boy. But that's not what this video is about. It's a little what this video is about. A lot of you probably know me from my first video on UL3741 that I released in February, even though that's not the timestamp on YouTube because of complicated reasons. Go check the description of that video. But before my last YouTube channel got taken down, that got several thousand views, still the highest viewed thing that I've made so far on YouTube. And what you might not know is that I have been following UL3741 very closely over the last year. I've actually made a website called UL3741 to track what products work with each other. If you have an inverter that's rated to work with a certain railing, you don't know that till you go to the railing's install manual, generally, most of the time. That information typically isn't on the inverter manufacturer's website. Sometimes it is. And it's not always easily findable on the internet on the railing manufacturer's website unless you go into their installation addendum for 3741. Anyway, I made a website to catalog and cross-reference all of these things. So if you've been following that website over the last year, there's gonna be some review here. But for those of you who have not been, let's talk about how solar has done with UL3741 over the last 7 months. Depends on how long it takes to edit this video. And for those of you who have followed UL3741, I am going to talk about the people I talked to at RE Plus and what their opinions are, what their plans are going down the road for 3741 compliance. I typically make chapters for these videos, so feel free to skip forward if you want to. Now, if you're new to this, definitely go watch my previous video to understand why I'm so passionate about 3741 and getting more systems certified to 3741. Basically, more reliable, less failures. That's what I'm going for. So to set the stage, back in February, of course, Ironridge and Tesla partnered together to make the first residential UL3741 system, which was significant. A lot of us in the solar industry never really thought or knew how we would get to residential 3741 compliance. We've had commercial options for a little while now, for a few years, but Ironridge and Tesla were the first residential 3741. Except were they? It turns out there's a number of other 3741 residential options as I was doing this research. And guess who they are? It's shingle systems. Of course, shingle systems would have to have this. I just didn't think about it before. So the two shingle systems that I found that are certified to 3741 is GAF Energy's Timberline shingle product and CertainTeed's Solstice solar product. And Timberline partners with Delta, an inverter manufacturer that also makes a string shutdown device. And CertainTeed partners with Growatt and Solis for their inverters and MidNite Solar for their shutdowns. And this is the same setup. We have string level rapid shutdown up to 600 volts. None of these systems are getting installed on commercial roofs, or I hope not. And personally, I have feelings about solar shingle roofs, but the big idea here is that Ironridge is not the only one. They were the first to a railed solution for 3741, which is itself a huge achievement. But it was just interesting to find out that there are other companies that had already done this in, I think, the year or two prior. Now, as the year went on, in around June and July, Unirac released two new listings for their next U-mount and their solar mount products. These are, like Ironridge's air racking and the XR racking, they're railed systems. Drill something into a roof, you have a rail across it, you slap the panels on it. Same type of thing. And Unirac, like Ironridge, listed Tesla's products to do the string level shutdown for residential systems. So unfortunately, not more selection on that front yet. But what had been an unaddressed part of the market so far is commercial roofs where you have huge but sloped roofs that you want to put solar on. You can't use ballasts because it's sloped, and so you need to put rails, but there's no 3741 option for that yet. It's even like these roofs are big enough that you can slap inverters on them. They're probably low slope enough that you can reasonably do service on them, but there just were no options. So Unirac is the first one to certify commercial inverters for their racking. I'm not going to list out all the inverters. You can go to 3741.com and get all of your 3741 questions answered. Basically, if you need solar on standing seam, on shingle, on corrugated metal, you freaking got options now. And of course, as with all other listings up to this point, Unirac is listing inverters specifically, the Tesla MCI device specifically, for compliance to 3741. Except right about that time, Pegasus contacted me about their racking system and their listing for 3741, which listed no inverter manufacturers. And that's wild. And you can go find this installation addendum. You can find their 3741 stuff. It lists no inverters. The insinuation is that any inverter or rapid shutdown device that is listed for their device type, I think 1741, is compatible and is acceptable with the Pegasus 3741 listing. And importantly, this listing is done through CSA. Most of the UL 3741 listings are currently done through Intertech. Almost none of them are done through UL specifically, because UL does not like certifying this kind of 3741 thing. But CSA is the only one who has done this sort of inverterless listing. Another manufacturer that's done it this way is TerraGen, which I think actually they do a better job in their installation instructions. They specifically say approved electrical equipment / inverters that are UL 1741 listed must have PVRSS or PVRSE functions certified by UL 1741 and follow the installation locations and guidance of this addendum. That seems pretty straightforward to me. Pegasus didn't say any of that. It was just kind of blank. I had to reach out to them specifically to make sure that this was what they meant. And I don't know, I have feelings about this, as well as, granted, the rest of the racking industry. I've talked to people that are very, very opposed to this being the way that this can happen, where you just allow any inverter, any rapid shutdown device for the purpose of 3741 compliance. And I don't really get why they're so vitriolically against it. I'm coming into this with prior code knowledge, right? So I have the understanding that it's written in the code specifically that even if you have a 3741 photovoltaic hazard control system in place, you still need to have array level shutdown. So that is the minimum. And what a lot of these racking manufacturers, what most of these racking manufacturers are doing is testing their system under array level shutdown restraints. So I don't super understand, and there's probably a better explanation for this that somebody can give me at some point, why up till now we have been duplicating what causes the array level shutdown. If any solar installation is supposed to have array level shutdown, period, I don't know why we need to tell exactly what device that should be in the 3741 listing. It's duplication, it's redundant. I don't get it, but a lot of people feel differently. Mostly racking manufacturers that have been doing all this work all this time and probably really don't want other people to not have to do that work to get their listings. But that's a more cynical take. That's not probably actually the reason. So that was a fun July and August to start working through all of that and start thinking about what this might mean going forward. I don't know if other racking manufacturers are going to adopt this or not. Time will tell. Now, aside from all that chaos, the other major milestone that we've seen in 3741 is now we have another string level shutdown device. And this comes from Ecofasten's listings of ClickFit and Rocket. Those names are way too close. I messed that up like six different times. They, of course, listed Tesla inverters, power walls, and their MCI-1. And they added another contender, which is MidNite Solar's MNSSR600S-SS, paired with Solis inverters. Now, this is a pretty major development because this is the only device that we've gotten that doesn't use proprietary communications in order to get the job done of shutting down. This is a SunSpec device. And yeah, I guess depending on how you look at it, it's proprietary technology, but SunSpec is the thing that works with the most things generally, or it seems like it might be the most accessible thing to just throw into an inverter. If you have an inverter with SunSpec compliance, there's a lot of them out there. An inverter manufacturer and racking company would not have to do all that much work to get this listed with their racking systems. Again, if 3741 continues to be the listing everything specifically with everything else type of listing. And then not too long after this, Ironridge also added this listing to their rackings as well. But no other inverters so far have come listed with this MidNite Solar device. But it's only been, geez, a month and a half. So we've got time. Oh, I can't believe I forgot Easy Solar. Easy Solar got listed with Ironridge's latest update to their Air and XR systems. They have wire management clip or like a zip tie replacement that is now listed. You can use that with Ironridge's 3741 system. You don't have to use Ironridge's clips. You can use a third party's because it's specifically listed with their installation addendum. But that brings us up to RE+. I went to RE+ hoping to get more news, more information about what companies were planning on for 3741 compliance or helping to reduce the pain of rapid shutdown in general. Now, what I was looking for is racking manufacturers that have yet to announce 3741 listings but are planning to, and to see if there are other inverter manufacturers or device manufacturers that have plans for string level shutdown devices. I talked to K2 for a while, actually. Look at this cool stuff they gave me. They gave me clamps and they got like this thing, the end clamp and stuff. It's fun. And this is a nice little box. Look at that. Sponsored. It's not sponsored. Sponsored. It's not sponsored. Not sponsored. They're working on listings for resi products. They've got a railed system, and what's the other kind of system? The one that you don't use rails, you just kind of put feet in there and you put the panels on and I don't know, it's gonna bug me and I'm not gonna think of it right now because I don't typically like those systems, but you know, I know people do. So you probably have an option in that pretty soon. The other manufacturer I talked to was Snap and Rack. They are working on it. They probably have something later this year. I think K2 also is looking at later this year. Not a lot longer left in this year. We got what, 3 months? Should get on that. Hopefully we'll be seeing some stuff soon. And in terms of string level shutdown stuff, I actually had a long interview with Tygo that I hope to edit and post for you guys, talking about comparisons between optimizer systems and 3741 systems and kind of pushing back on how they feel about 3741 versus how I feel about how they feel about 3741. And it was a great conversation. It was good talking to JD. It does sound like Tygo is looking into making a string level shutdown device for the purposes of 3741. Not any more details than that. I also think SMA is working on it. They actually have a new shutdown product this year that they were showing that I will have a video on that here soon if I haven't posted it already. I think it's called their Smart Shutdown.
It's gonna be a SMA Smart Shutdown.
I'm pretty sure it's called their Smart Shutdown. But the idea, anyway, very much like the Tesla string shutdown, their MCI-1, is you put one of these every three modules. So it cuts down the need for rapid shutdown devices from one per panel, or maybe two per panel if you're using the Tygo 2 per panel thing, to now one per three panels. And they've actually designed it to be nice for installers to use, which is cool. The idea is these are rail mounted, not panel mounted, and they have really long leads on one end, I think up to what, 14, 15 feet, something like that. So instead of attaching, this is what we've been doing for rapid shutdown devices, is attach the rapid shutdown device to the panel and then wire manage all that, lay the panel down, click in between the panels, and wire manage the panels. You put the rail down, you put the shutdown devices on, you wire all that up, you wire manage all that, and then you just start plugging panels together and then into the rapid shutdown device, and it's much, much nicer. At least theoretically. It also has an LED on it that will let you know if it's not working, or if it's working, which also is way better than what we've had so far. But again, as with all new products, I remain skeptical until proven that my skepticism is silly, because I've been burned by these things before. Not specifically by SMA, but by these things before. And ultimately what I'd expect to see from SMA, this is not something they told me, but probably a string level device of this same sort of footprint, where you have just a string coming in and plugging into this thing, and then it just breaks the voltage from the roof to the ground, make that really nice and simple. And I hope that we see it sooner than later. But this potentially also could work for commercial installations as well, though they haven't sorted that out yet, the 3-to-1 thing. There's also a company that I talked to called AUO, which has this device for, it's basically a box that does in and out. It doesn't do any combining. It is just in and out for arc fault detection, which is pretty cool. They had a whole thing set up there to demonstrate what an arc fault detection device looks like with the ball and the ring. And that was super cool. I really enjoyed that. But they're working on an iteration for rapid shutdown. You'd put it right next to the array, send a signal to it, shuts down whenever you need to, specifically for array level stuff. Now, anything they do, is they're going to need to integrate with chosen inverter manufacturers to figure out to how to get those listings. Assuming again that that's how most racking manufacturers are going to keep doing it, but this is a potential interesting option in the future for array level rapid shutdown. The possibilities are opening up and I'm enjoying people talking about a bunch of different options. So anyway, it's been a big year for 3741. And it's definitely not even the end of the year. Like I said, there are going to be racking manufacturers we'll probably see listings from by the end of the year. There's also going to be an update to the 3741 standard itself. And I hear that that's probably going to be before the end of the year as well. Who knows exactly what's going to be in that? Because I know there's a lot of people that are really upset about how 3741 is being listed by a lot of companies. Mostly their names rhyme with Olersedge, but it does sound like there are things that can get tightened up with the standard. The main thing that I've heard through the grapevine is wire management is going to be more strictly addressed in the next standard, which I'm fine with. I am for wire management being more prescriptive and being less like, I don't know, keep the wires up there. But anyway, be prepared to see differences to the 3741 standard. Again, we don't really know what that looks like yet. And again, if this is something that you really care about, I am going to keep updating ul3741.com with any details that I have. And if you find something that's wrong on the website, you can submit a ticket to get me to fix it, which I would be very, very grateful for. Exciting times, changing times, hopefully better times coming soon, hopefully less rapid shutdown, hopefully more reliable systems. That's my whole thing as a solar boy. I want more reliable systems. I don't want to have to go out to fix people's systems as much as I am. And I know I'm not the only one. Going to a place like RE Plus gives me so much faith in the solar industry that we're going to just continue to figure our stuff out. Every industry has problems. The solar industry is no exception. But we've got good people, smart people, thinking about these things constantly. And we're just going to keep getting better. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you. I would love to hear your comments about what you think about this whole storied 2024 for solar in terms of rapid shutdown, and 3741, because everybody's got a different perspective, and I don't hear nearly enough of them. So with that, stay shiny, and I'll see you next time.